Hello there. We are back with Tweak the Week, our weekly show of news and current events, which we don't understand. And because of that, we bring it for you. So this time, what didn't we understand? So a typical scenario is if you go to a hotel and don't like the hotel food, you start cooking at home. Now, if you extend that to another level, you can say, okay, I'm staying in the village. The panchayat has not built the road for me. So I'll make my own road and drive my own car on that. Now, the problem is when governments and industry starts doing it, what happens in such a case? Hi, Bala. What do you think? What happens when something like this happens?
That's an interesting intro, Raj. I mean, that's pretty intriguing. Not just interesting, intriguing. I guess we are segueing into the new home social media platform that Indian government is trying to foist or push.
Yes.
Yes. Twitter. Is that what you are getting at?
Yes. So if I don't like Twitter, I'll start something else. If I don't like some other platform, I don't know, tomorrow we might not like Microsoft, we'll start, something else. I don't know. So what's your take on that? I mean, first of all, how did this come about, Bala? I mean, I think it's interesting to sort of just step back.
How did this come about? Yeah. I mean, we are talking about the social media platform in the coup. The government is trying to create a coup.
Before the coup came into effect, exactly.
That's what I mean. Before we start to talk about the coup was stopped. Yeah. The need for coup, at least in the eyes of the government and the guys who are in the right-wing segment, is because Twitter is trying to be, it is holding firm against some of the orders of the Indian government. Indian government wanted a few handles in the light of the ongoing farmers' protest. It wanted few handles to be deplatformed or removed or silenced. For which Twitter was not willing in the first stage. In the second stage, it kind of gave in, it kind of removed a few handles. But government is still not convinced. So that's the reason why coup has come in.
Yeah. So see, it's interesting. I mean, before we get to coup again, that coup word itself sounds very interesting because...
It's K-double-O. K-double-O.
Yeah, coup. So, I mean, the earliest coup I remember in my life was my daughter calling herself that. Which is weird, but so when they said coup is being launched, I said, but then that got launched 25 years ago. What is the big deal here?
It's a big deal. For us Tamilians, it's a totally off the cuff remark. In the sense, for us Tamilians, coup is actually a short form for a bad word.
Yeah. So we will not go there. Because this is a family show, we won't utter bad words unless forced to. Bala, I have another question for you, man. See, we leave coup aside. Now, from Twitter's point of view, because see, Twitter is also intriguing, right? I remember reading yesterday that Twitter first banned the American president when he was president. And now I get to hear that he will remain banned for life. Right? Yes. There you're going directly against the government. And here you're sort of falling in line with the government. I mean, what are you trying to do?
There are two ways of looking at it, Raj. It's at the end of the day, it's a private entity. Twitter makes its own rule. It decides it doesn't want Donald Trump on its platform. Fine. But Twitter it doesn't want to do the bidding of another government.
Okay.
It's a private entity. That's one way of it. I'm not saying Twitter is right or wrong. I'm saying Twitter thinks it's slightly rich on the part of Twitter to think that the Indian government, what it decides is right and what the Indian government decides is not wrong. That's one way of looking at it. Another way how can you say just because the Indian government decides something is anti-national, and everybody is anti-national in this climate in India right now. So just because the Indian government and the backers of the Indian government say few of the handles are anti-national, should everyone give up? I mean, it is another way of failing this.
Yeah, so I have a very interesting theory also here. So just to pun on the word coup, in the US, they actually were part of the coup. In India, they are actually against the coup, or the coup is against them.
That is true.
Yeah. And the other thing is, one more thing, Bala, other thing that comes to mind immediately is that there it was easier to stage a coup because Trump was anyways going. I mean, it was only a matter of time before he went. here the Modi government is not going anywhere in the short term, at least.
Or at least it doesn't look like. Anyway, that's not for us to say, but besides the point, but it was a strange thing. I mean, the government put out a press release. I mean, it first put out that tweet on coup, then of course it also shared it on Twitter, that while agreeing to a meeting with the government, the Twitter officials put out a long-winded kind of a self-explanatory blog post. That was kind of, you know, because it suggested that, I mean, it was very loaded. If you had read that blog post, it was loaded, and it kind of suggested what Indian government was demanding from the Twitter was not exactly commensurate with the Indian laws. It was not spelled out as explicitly, but the suggestion was that. That was weird. Just ahead of the meeting with the government for Twitter to come out, it was kind of, I mean, it was slight of, I mean, it was slightly unbecoming of the Twitter, I mean, of a platform of Twitter speech.
So in other words, what I understand from you, Bala, is that, I mean, basically government went ahead and announced coup, as in like the K00 coup, and Twitter responded with its own coup on Twitter.
Let's be very clear. Twitter is not getting into the coup thing at all. It is just that Indian government, which is slightly cut off with Twitter, is trying to project coup as an alternative. And Raj, let's be very clear. This is something which is being backed by this right-wing ecosystem. Mohandas Pai's son is one of those venture capitalists behind this coup. But a previous venture, something on those similar lines, something called Gab, it tried to come about 6 months back, but it didn't take off much in India. There was an initial talk. And there is something similar in America too. Parler, you would have heard about it. Parler. Yeah. So that didn't go anywhere. So Twitter has got nothing to do with coup, but it is just that the Indian government, which is out of spite with Twitter, which is trying to project coup as an alternative. But I have my doubts whether it will actually take off or not.
So now my point is, Bala, see, look at it this way. So here is a thought. When government has a problem with Twitter, so they say we are all going on coup, and they know that there is a make in India, made in India brand of nationalism, Atmanirbhar Bharat nationalism going on. So when government says, okay, we are all on coup, so it is almost like telling Twitter, you know what, you fall in line, or the coup is spelt differently for you.
Differently.
So, yeah, exactly. So and then.
But Raj, then, you brought up a good point. I mean, the position in your point is it right for seeing it? We always have a problem with big technological platforms trying to call shots, not just in India, elsewhere too. See, you have Google, Facebook, YouTube, Apple. All these people, all these platforms, all these technological, technology corporates, they're growing too big for their own good. And they are kind of undermining democracy in different. See, all said and done, it's a legally and democratically elected government which is asking Twitter to do something on the basis of what it sees. And if Twitter cannot say that it will not do it, because rightly or wrongly, the Indian government sees certain handles as being problematic. So Twitter is also undermining democracy. It is an argument. I'm not saying this is this way. So
yeah,
what is your view on this?
This is probably a topic for discussion on a longer level, because somehow feel that the bigger the companies, the more clout they have with the governments, and the more they use that clout to get more people and to make more money. Now, how do they make money? Twitter is not obviously in the league of Facebook when it comes to making money. But the point Twitter, I think, which we have spoken about earlier also, is that algorithms are the ones that define who sees what. And if I am anti-BJP, I'll only see anti-BJP tweets more. If I am pro-BJP, I'll see more pro-BJP tweets. So
they
it's essentially
kind of an echo chamber.
Yes. So they are pushing, all of these social media channels are pushing you towards an echo chamber. So from my point of view, the government saying that, look, coup is there, I mean, I'm fine with it. See, this is again like a bit like a TikTok.
But the problem
and that,
is, coup is also a right-wing echo chamber.
No, the point is, like Bala, you said, I don't think coup is going to stage a coup. Well, that sounds weird.
Yeah, that is, that's what I'm getting to. It's not good.
Yeah,
see,
yeah it is not.
Coup also has a problem, both in terms of technology. It's a pale shadow of Twitter.
Yeah, so that is, see, we can, that's what I was going to say. If you look at all the, post the Galwan Valley incident, we went ahead and banned X number of Chinese apps. And then suddenly you had this big hangama about IT company, or rather VC, even VC is going up, I mean, up and running and saying, okay, anyone who has an idea which equals any of the Chinese apps, please come to us. So see, this is all a money-making thing. I don't think this really,
right.
really brings ethics, governance, or any of these issues into play. It is all about money, honey. I mean, there was an ad, you remember? It's all about money, exactly. Honey. Money, yeah. Honey, so it's all about money. Yeah. So it's all about honey, but, money, but, and everything.
You're right. It's all about money, honey. But some of our serious issues get bundled into this, and those are the issues, because big tech companies undermining democracies, or right-wing ecosystem trying to hijack something as important as Indian. What do I say? I mean, what is the word I'm looking for? I really don't know. India's kind of self-expressions in terms of technology and other things. Those things get washed away in this.
See, the idea is simple. See, today, for example, I mean, in another program which we did recently, we talked about the companies that are there in the market who need to sort of bring in indigenization or localization to a level where you can actually say make in India. So one of our colleagues in a different platform, he actually went to see a factory of a electronic bike or electrical bike just next to Bangalore in Tamil Nadu, Hosur. Now, those guys have managed to indigenize up to 90-95%. And the only thing which for them still requires import is lithium cells, which runs the bike. And because we don't have lithium deposits, that needs to be imported. So it is the same. You can't sort of mimic something which is working in the West, copy it and say, this is make in
That's
India. That
point.
Is rubbish.
That's a good point. That's right. A good point. Yeah. But just to lighten the mood, I mean, your point is pretty valid and everything, because I'm right there with you. See, I don't know whether you've gotten into coup, because just to do a story, I did a story for the platform that we are working for. I did a story on coup. So just for professional reasons, I kind of registered myself on coup and just checked out what is happening. Bulk of the handles are from the right-wing ecosystem. But the thing that really caught my fancy was for a retweet, the equivalent of a retweet, it is called a recoup.
I wonder what they call mentions, because that could be crazy also, right? I mean, so
I don't know. And
what do we? Okay, now Bala, I want to ask you another very serious question here. If Twitter is to Twitterati, what is coup? Kurati? No, I don't know.
I mean, there are some very bad words. Then again, there are some bad conjugations with Tamil words. I don't want to get that.
Southern languages, people who speak Southern languages, they would have got the hint by now. I don't think we should mention those words.
My lips are sealed.
Yes. So, I mean, I really don't want to be called as a Kurati. I mean, so which is probably the one reason I might not be on coup, at least in the short term. But then, Bala, it's coming to a serious challenge. I mean, what does this tell of the way governance on one hand and corporate governance on the other hand are going towards? They seem to be fighting. So first thing to me is, does it really matter? Because how many Indians are on Twitter? What percentage of Indians are on Twitter? Do you really care about something where, you know, less than 1% of people are there? I really don't know. I think we mentioned this last time when everybody and their uncles and aunts went after a few tweets, and in the process, we forgot the farmers.
You're right. Twitter is hardly a microcosm of the world that we live in, or the society that we are part of. You are exactly right. But somehow, the Twitter and Facebook or even YouTube, they have a presence or a personality that is disproportionate to their actual size or the importance in our day-to-day. But let's face it, American elections, Twitter and Facebook were an important part. Whether we like it, that has come to be. I mean, that's a hard reality. You're right, it is irrelevant, but
So here is the thing. Here is the thing. I mean, India is not America, right? I mean, in India, people still, the Indian, first of all,
These are the platforms that the leaders, not just leaders, any social celebrity, actors, even journalists, they use it to convey information. And this is, at one level, it's also be very honest. It's easy to get connected with people. A lot of good things have, I'll not openly this social media platform. not just Twitter or Facebook, because a lot of good things have also come out of it.
I agree.
It has also helped grassroots democracy. As you said, these are getting things which are very elaborate. We'll discuss it sometime later.
So I agree with your point. See, my only claim is that, is it that important that you need to build that? I mean, instead of, like I said in the beginning, do you need to build a road because you feel that the road that has been built is not good enough for
it's
you?
It's all so just brownie, political, road. Just more political, yeah. Brownie points, just bragging rights.
So that is right. One. Yeah, that is bragging rights. And coming back to the corporate governance side, you can't have different rules for different countries and different people. So Facebook is
that's
the same.
You are right. See, Twitter cannot cock a snook at a democratically elected government.
Yes. And similarly, see, we brought this up in another episode, if you guys remember, about WhatsApp. See, WhatsApp has different rules in the United States and different rules in India. So in India, everything goes. In the US, it doesn't, because the law is slightly stricter there. And today, just to sort of conclude this argument, I mean, from my side, today I was reading that Facebook and Twitter are now joining hands to go and present before the American authorities as to why they should not be downsized and why they should be a single entity. Now, you see how comfortable it is for them to sort of ensure that their hegemony continues.
Yeah.
Now, this is where the conflict is.
Because there is a vested interest at play.
Yes.
Whether we like it, I mean, you're right. Because I know for a fact, at a personal level, that you have certain amount of cynicism towards this tech conglomerates, because you see a problem, because you have always talked about, I'm just private, because you have a problem with Google being too large in size, because that is what is happening with Twitter and other social media. It's not me,
it is the rest of the world. I mean, governments, rest of the world. So it is nothing new here. So my point is that, this battle is...
But having said that, see, here the problem is, the Indian government is also not totally blemished. So,
yeah, it'll never be, right? See, when you are dealing with a blemish, when you are dealing with a blemish, you sort of deal with a blemish with another blemish. You are not trying to clean up the mess that is there, which you can't. So, because you don't have clearly defined cyber laws, I think somewhere along the line, I think that's what is required. There needs to be a well thought out, cutting across party lines. Government should come together and define what is allowed, what is not allowed. So I think till that happens.
You're right. The larger point is, see, Twitter at the end of the day is an American entity.
Yes.
So it will not be bothered about what India wants. And there is also a larger question whether Indian government will bite the bullet and ban Twitter. I don't think that is going to happen, because it would still need Twitter. Because often I can tell you only four governments have banned Twitter outright. China, Turkmenistan, North Korea, and Iran. And these four countries are not exactly known for their democracy.
And then, so here is a funny situation, Bala. Just imagine the situation. We have a scenario where, like you said, we don't believe, both of us don't believe that Twitter will be banned by government. If it is, then we will come back and do another episode. And we also don't think that the Twitter competitor, the so-called competitor will go anywhere beyond coup. As in, like, it will stay at coup only. Even another O will not come next to the existing two O's.
As a final point, I'll see whatever advertisement that who kind of needs it, it has to be done on Twitter. See, everybody is saying that on Twitter that you come to Coop.
Yeah, this is like we said. I mean, we all diss WhatsApp, but then where do we share our angst on WhatsApp? So this is where we all are, ladies and gentlemen. So
our life is a paradox.
Yeah, so the paradox continues. So it's really, really doesn't matter whether coup comes in or Twitter continues, because at the end of the day, all of these things make a very little difference in each of our personal lives. I think it's a good idea to remember that, because at the end of the day, they are irrelevant. Beyond a point, they are irrelevant. Like Bala said, there's a lot that you can do with it, but then if it goes beyond, you can ignore it. Tomorrow, if it is my right to get off Twitter or on Twitter, nobody else can do anything about it. What do you say, Bala? That's the thought I have. Sobering thought.
You summed it up nicely. It's important as much as, but the importance, the level of importance, it should be decided by the people who use it. That's about it.
That is about it. So on that note, I think we'll end the show. Thank you very much for watching, and keep sharing your views and liking us and sharing our videos. So it will be available on Facebook, and it's obviously there on the YouTube channel called Bits and Banter. And we are also on Spotify and what else, Bala? That's it.
We are on Anything Twitter, else? But we are not on
Koo. Yeah, we have still not been cooed. So with a coo to you, see you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye, Raj. Thank you. Thank you.